Hello New Angelist, this is Shorty again, live unfiltered and uncensored for the Throwback Tournament as a benefits tournament for the Hemophilia Society at Manitoba, Canada. And round two is coming up right now. Last round was quite fun, that was entertaining. The first game was more of a conservative build from both sides, but the rematch, the second round of the game, that was quite original. So both players really put some effort into the decks and pretty much a lot of thinking into it. And I hope we will see the same thing on round two here. So round two is up. Let's see, what game should we jump in? We can watch. How's about Osgillate versus Lost Geek? That sounds like fun. This is on table 13. So we wait until Lost Geek joins also the table, and then I will ask if it's fine if they are being recorded. Okay, just ask Osgillate already. And we will ask Lost Geek later when he joins. I don't think anybody has anything against it. And oh yeah, Analyze Chris. Seems like he swept round one. Yes, my secret favorite, you know. Go Analyze Chris and win this tournament so that I was right. So Osgillate is fine with being recorded. Let's wait for Lost Geek. We can check what are the identities that we will see. Let's switch. So Osgillate is on Sync and Hoshiko Shiro. Hoshiko can be pretty much everything. Sync could be mid-season, could be breaking news, could be seesaws into Scorched Earth. I think this will be 100% a kill deck. And Lost Geek is on Sports Metal. Cool, this could be, I don't know, Domestic Sleeper 1 million agenda points Sports Metal. Or, I don't know, let's see, and we have 419, which can be on Account Siphon, of course, or Desperado. Okay, so, the game is up. Osgillate is playing her Sync against 419, against Lost Geek's 419. Good luck, have fun. Game doesn't start yet. We go for the bigger fonts and the bigger chat. Sorry for the screaming in the background. Child number two is making some trouble, like it seems. Sync. This also I love the name Throwback for the tournament because it's really a throwback, and my mind is throwing back to 2016 when Sync was released with the Data and Destiny. It was such a strong identity back in those days, because the additional cost from the tags with the Data Ravens and the breaking news, and it was just so good. And it's still a 40 card deck, so you have the opportunity to play Very fewer genders, and with Bellona also hitting the table or hitting the card pool here, I think that is doable. You can go for mid-season then. And I'm very curious what will happen here. Let's see if Sync can bring up some money against 419, because the 419 econ denial will be real. So 419 has the first time the corp installs a card each turn, you may expose that card unless the corp pays one. Okay, Osglade keeps her hand, Lost Geek takes a mulligan. And we start with a classic Hedge 4 into Ice HQ, paying 1 to prevent the ice from being exposed, and installing an ice into a new remote. Okay, leaving R&D open here, could be abused with an early armor core, but he needs also to be careful against hard-hitting news, because hard-hitting news is still here. Okay, Lost Geek is drawing and taking credit to install a Dany cast. Okay, this is mostly a setup turn just to make sure you have some money, because no pressure yet from the Sync deck. Installing something into server 1, it's exposed, it's on Rashida, resing the Rashida to prevent Lost Geek from exposing this with falsified credentials to gain some money early on. And the Rashida behind an ice sounds fine. I don't think Lost Geek will contest it, Rashida, that's not worth it. Installing an upgrade in HQ, hopefully a Crisium grid against account siphons, and saving R&D with an ice. That was a good turn, I would say. Maybe it's not a Crisium, this is just a guess, but... Okay, Dirty Laundry Archives. Bravado, okay, he's contesting server 1. Bravado into only a ice wall. So what does that mean? Why does Sync play Ice Wall? Because you want to play Consulting Visit and you need those low influence Wayland cards. Maybe there is Scorched Earth. Playing free Scorched Earth, free Ice Wall, then you can play the Consulting Visit without paying the influence. We don't know yet, but the Rashida is coming through. Drawing a lot of cards here. But Lost Geek is on a safe spot with 12 credits, also against the hard-hitting news, because you always need to think about that you need not only 2, but you need 3 credits to remove a single tag with Sync. So that means that hard-hitting news, you need 12 credits to remove all 4 tags. Osglade is going for install ice on server 1 into putting something into server 1. Okay, bravadoing the HQ here, maybe just to check if it's possible to go for account siphon. I'm very looking forward for the boomerangs into account siphons, the good old doofarang, like the power creep doofarang. Imagine what the times back in the days would have been when boomerang would be there already, when account siphon was legal. Wow, so broken. But it's a data raven. Okay, but he forces the res, he gains some money, and he draws Osglade some money for resing the data raven, and you know what you need. And here we have the Dean Lister. There is the throwback card. The Dean Lister can be dressed, and you can choose an icebreaker, and until the end of the run that icebreaker has +1 strength for each card in your grip, which means you can install an Aumakua and pretty much face check everything with enough cards in hand. But that means there is no account siphon. Only one throwback card is allowed, and this one, Lost Geek, or this time Lost Geek decided for the Dean Lister, which sounds like a fine idea. Okay, Osglade doing a slow turn here, just drawing up, playing the IPO for some more money. Okay, there is the Aumakua. you could go for R&D here and you can face check pretty much everything. Playing a deuce is wild, pretty much exposing one ice, I'm very sure, and gaining some money. Okay, outermost ice on R&D and server 1 is also a data raven, a good ice. Here we have the IP block. Oh man, no. No, last click. Running there. Take the tag. But he still have the second trigger from the deuces wild, so he can remove the tag with the deuces wild afterwards. But the ice placement is quite good here. The IP block on R&D with the Aumakua. Make sure you won't run R&D too often with that Aumakua. And the data ravens makes it very expensive and very click intensive to remove the tags afterward if you don't have anything that, like networking or any shenanigans against tags. So fire all. He can break it, or he can break it using the team lifter here, but I also don't think that's worth it. Just let it trace through. It's stress free, means you need 2 credits. 2 credits, so don't get additional tag, and using the deuces wild to remove the tag you get from the IP block. Ooh, that was ballsy, Lost Geek. But now he has a lot of information about the board state. Okay, triple advancing in server 1, it's a beal. Okay, first 2 points, not too bad for Lost Geek here. Could be much worse. Oscillate also only on 8 credits, so Lost Geek has the credit lead at the moment. Daily cast was ticking out. Just drawing up, looking for some options, I think. Ah, there's a bankroll. Oh yeah, that really sounds like the criminals before Nisei take over this beautiful game. Bankroll. I think Bankroll is pretty much an underused card, also in the current card pool, even without the throwback format. I think Bankroll and Aumakua is cool. Oscillate, install a card in server 1, paying 1 from prevented being exposed, which is fine because you don't want the Aumakua tokens to stack up, and going for a double advance that pretty much I think is a Bellona. I would just run server 1 just to force the rest on the data raven. There's nothing to be scared of. If she don't rest the data raven, you can break the ice wall with 1 credit and check if it's really an NGO. Might also be a Bellona, but you can also steal a Bellona if you want to and click up there for credits afterwards. As long as you have the credit lead, okay, going for another bankroll and forcing the res. Forcing the data raven res. And yeah, okay, that's pretty sure an NGO. You can just bounce off here and maybe run archives once, just for the bankrolls and for the Aumakuas. I don't know how many ice the sync deck is really running. Can the sync deck really ice up all centrals? I don't know. An IP block on archives might be a good idea before the bankrolls really get out of hand. To ice up archives and being able to rest that ice. IP block would be perfect here. Yeah, what else? That is the NGO. That was not unexpected, but that's still fine. You need those credits. And the rest data raven is always okay. There's an economic warfare. This sounds like hard hitting news. Maybe no Scorched Earth, because with 3 economic and 3 ice walls you also have enough Wayland cards to go for the consulting visit without paying the influence. And I'm pretty sure we will see the hard hitting news here. Too bad that there is the hard hitting news. Too bad Lost Geek don't have enough credits to remove all four tags. Oh, that hit was good. That was a good fake with that NGO. Osclade knew exactly here what to do. She knew she had the hard-hitting news, she had the economic warfare and the NGO, so she was confident about raising that Data Raven for future value. And now Lost Geek has the 4 tags and only 7 credits. He can remove, I think, 3 tags if he pops both bank rolls to get out of the boom range. Nah, but boom is offline. Osclade don't have enough money for the boom. I think he can take his time, maybe discarding 2 tags and clicking for 2 credits, which sounds terrible, slow and boring, but you need to be a little bit careful here. Roskick giving this a good think. Okay, there is a spearfishing, bypassing the data raven. Why spearfishing? Is he also running free inside jobs? Because you only run spearfishing when you're already running free inside jobs, I think. Maybe I'm totally wrong. Also love that fam, by the way. I love that artwork. That artwork is so genius. Wow, it is one of the best artworks in the whole game. So Lost Geek want to check what's the upgrade on HQ, and maybe want to check if there is any agendas in HQ. So we have seen the Beal. So there are 3 Beal, maybe 3 Bellona. Then you're already on 15 agenda points, but that is not enough. With a 44 card deck, you need 18 agenda points at least. So 3 agenda points is missing. Could be 3 fly on the wall, maybe. Oh, it's a Mwanza city grid. Oh my holy moly. Oh shit. So he is accessing a lot from HQ. Okay, there is a Bellona. And afterwards, Osclade will be so rich. She will be so rich. She will gain 8 credits, which brings her back on 10, and oh man. Oh, this is looking grim here. This is looking grim. I've seen some of the sync decks with Mwanza in the last few months, weeks, I don't know. I think it's a good include. It's only 1 influence. This card is just so insane. Also a cool artwork, by the way. Okay, there is a boom. There is a boom, so he just saved himself. And we see a Bellona, which he not steal, and a toll booth. Oh, what is this? Another spear fishing on R&D. Okay. So he also didn't trash the Mwanza. He didn't care if she gets those credits, because mostly you want to trash the Mwanza if you want to run the server more than once, because every time she will get so many credits. Okay, and now popping the bankrolls and going for the apocalypse. Oh, I was here. This is going to be a apoc build. Wow, yes, yes. The bankrolls are perfect for apoc, and the Dean Lister is also trashable, and you don't care about if one Aumakua gets trashed. But there is still Osclade is on 12 credits, have 3 clicks, and Lost Geek is still on 4 tags. So if she draws archive memories, a casaltic visit, a boom, I don't know what she can draw a lot, and Lost Geek is done. So Lost Geek is gambling here. That hit still was beautiful. Look what he trashed. He trashed Wanza, he trashed two Data Ravens, which are so important for Sync. That IP block from R&D, okay, that ice wall, well, it's gone. Everything here. Well, it kinda screams Apoc, doesn't it? The bank rolls. The spear phishing, so there are three inside job for sure and three spear phishing and the Apoc, yeah, this pretty much smelled like Apoc, but what can you do? Nothing you can do about it. At least in Osglade's situation for the moment. I'm sorry for the screaming. Kids are always loud and screaming. But that's fine. Kids that are silent and not screaming around all day, then you know something is going wrong. So, Osglade installing her last Data Raven, which was exposed on HQ, which is still a good defense against the Diversion of Funds, which might be in the deck or surely will be in the deck of Lost Geek. So Lost Geek has pretty much an open R&D here. Still, I think he still needs to get rid of the tech somehow at one point of time. He saw one boom and yeah, well, that's the decision. Do you want to go super broke and lose all your tempo for removing the tags? And he can't remove all tags this turn, he can only remove two tags. Okay, there's the diversion. He might decide to go tag me. Okay, no res. Getting the monies. Running R&D here, seeing an unseen card, nothing. Going HQ again, as long as she don't rest. There's the Bellona, maybe this time you steal it. Yes, okay. So I think Lost Geek decided that it's not worth to remove any of those tags. If the Data Raven would be rest, I think he might have just go through and say, okay, you know what, fuck it, let's just keep the aggression up. It's a breaking news. What? Oh, okay, yeah, well, so there is the throwback card. The throwback card is the breaking news, which means if you can install double advance something in a remote server and score it next turn, you can just boom and it's GG. Or you can just install it and go in double advance, boom, next turn. So yeah, breaking news, we all know. No, we know the drill of breaking news. I love the agenda, by the way. I'm sad that it's gone. But yeah, it was causing a lot of problems back in the days. A lot of degenerate decks, if I think about those. What was those called? Those Railgun NEH decks, wow, they were so strong and it was so hard to play against them. But I love the style. Somehow I relate breaking news with Netrunner. I don't know, it was one of the first cards I've seen and I still love the breaking news. Okay, and Lusky cares a little bit of luck here in accessing a Beal from the open R&D, bringing Lost Geek maybe to game point if you don't steal the breaking news. So we have 3 Bellona, which is 9, 3 Project Beal is 15, and 3 breaking news is 18. That's pretty much the agenda suit, I suppose, from Osglade. I hope the audio is fine, I'm not too sure. So the microphone is quite new. I don't know if it's too near to my face. Maybe it's too far away from my face. I hope the audio is good. So Lost Geek is checking what kind of eyes would kill him. also a run on R&D. There was an IP block getting in another tag because another OmaQS install. Yeah, I think right now LostGeek is like, oh, you know what, I'm gonna stick to the tags and just try my best to find the last bill or another Bellona, while Osclade is still economic warfaring him, installing ice on archives, which is a Mauselos. Wow, all those nasty splashes. And I'm pretty sure there's another Mwanza somewhere. But LostGeek is still on 6 tags, so that archive memory consulting visit boom threat is still live. And he's only on 1 credit. I mean, he can check HQ, it's only a data raven. He can force the res, otherwise he can maybe farm some Omakua tokens to get up to 4 to run R&D once per turn by breaking the IP block, at least the last subroutine from the IP block. And uses wild, drawing 2 cards, gaining 3 credits. Osclade installing a card in server 3, okay. Another breaking news, okay, just scoring this out, yeah. But that doesn't help too much. This doesn't bring her. Okay, this technically she could be on game point by scoring a Bellona next time, but I don't see how she will ever be able to score the Bellona. She has 0 remote servers, she has no money yet. I think she might be the best just to concentrate on the kill here and find your kill piece. Find a kill piece, because if LostGeek steals one of the breaking news, it's not the end of the world. He's still on game point then. Another use is wild, drawing up again, getting some more money. Okay, no res on HQ, not enough money. Another economic warfare in hand. Now he has enough counters for the turtle to get through the IP block. Breaking only the last sub, I'm guessing. Okay, approaching R&D and only 17 cards left, and I think 1, 2, 3, still 4 agendas. This is a 1 in 4 chance. But he could go for another APOC at one point of time. I'm sure there is another APOC we can count. Oh, there's the exchange. Okay, yeah. Exchanging the breaking news for Bellona, bringing Osclade on 6 points and LostGeek only on 3 points. Stealing the last credits from him, clicking for a credit. So the last breaking news could be the winning agenda for Osclade here. She has a lot of outs, but she don't have the money. And LostGeek is trying to block all agendas from R&D. So that R&D lock is real. Maybe she just needs to draw up maybe 3 times. Just to break the R&D lock. Another Mwanza would be good. Deciding to install ice on R&D. It's a slot machine, which can be broken because Omakua has 7 tokens. Maybe next turn she's going for the purge. LostGeek is clicking up for credits. Discarding a daily cast. Yeah, the daily cast will be trashed, quite sure, if you install it. This turn a fresh card from R&D, or an unseen card from R&D, and clicking for the credits. I think the end of the game might be near here. least, you don't have enough credits. The purge right now is not worth anything. If you cannot rest the HQ ice and the archive ice, and the HQ ice is only the Data Raven, maybe the purge isn't even worth anything. Because Lost Geek might decide to go through HQ ice and getting two tags per turn. Who cares? One by the trace and one maybe by the token. You don't care. Curious, maybe there is no kill in Osgalade's deck besides the one boom. Maybe she has a psychographic. She could psychographic out the Bellona, she could psychographic out pretty much everything here. Okay, making a run on R&D. Forcing the rest of the slot machine. What we see? Delica, Sneakto, Beta, Ballsy, and an Eater. Okay. Breaking one sub. Only cost a single credit. Another credit for the end the run subroutine by the IP block. Getting another tag. Seeing a card from R&D and still nothing. And discarding all those resources you never are able to play. This game went totally different than I was expecting it. Lost Geek was playing very safely early, but yeah, against Sync, that hard-hitting news and the economic warfare, at one point of time you might want to run. This would happen to me. Like in turn 2, I would be tagged in turn 2 and maybe lose the game in turn 3. So no worries here. Okay, there is a preemptive action. Bringing back the boom. Okay, so there is no archived memories, I'm guessing. And bringing back two economics, which are just for the money drain. Still the Sneak Door, an Eater, and a Show Gamble, okay. Running R&D for 2 credits, at one point of time he might be lucky here. He might want to snipe. Or he wants to snipe on agenda. Oh, no! He's finding the boom again, trashing the boom again. Might really be the only boom in the deck. We can count a little bit the influence. So we have 3 economics, which was 6. We have at least 1 Mwanza, which is 7. With the boom, we have 10. We have 11 with the ice wall. The Mausolus, I'm not sure. There's at least 2 influence, which is 13. So I think there's only 1 boom. There might be only 1 boom. And is it game? No, it's not game. It's no. I'm sorry. I was thinking this might be click one, but it was draw a card, playing economic warfare to steal Lost Geek all his monies, and just installing a card in server 4. What could this be? I think you might be tempted to run it. Okay, falsified guessing asset is under Rashida, getting 5 credits out of it. Okay. Now you can run the Rashida to trash it, I think you need to, and then run R&D again. And those big turtle, where you can do nothing about it. You can do nothing about it. Sorry, needed to head out for a second, so he was He was finding an Rashida in the remote and finding another Rashida in HQ. So all three Rashidas out. Only 11 cards left, okay. Oh man, and Osglade still only on 4 credits, so she purchases, okay. Purchase on 4 credits, but Losky can just run HQ like a madman to get back on at least the mandatory 4 for the IP block. Okay, discarding the sneak door, playing a short gamble, just drawing up a little bit. And there might be another Dean Lister. Which can be a one-off R&D run. Oh man, running against Sync when you see the boom with 12 tags, yeah. That one time when he trashed the boom from the top of R&D that was just reshuffled, that was gold. That was pure gold. Okay, now Osglade is switching out the HQ ice, trashing the Data Raven, just to switch it out for another ice, might be an IP block, even ice wall would be fine, just something to keep the Aumakua out. Lost Geek, face checking here, click 1, HQ ice, okay, slot machine, that's something you can live with. There are diversions, first time we've seen some diversions, so there might be a diversion in hand. And an IP block in hand. I'm wondering why she didn't decide to put the IP block on HQ. I don't think the slot machine is that good. The IP block at least has a hard end to run with strength 4. So we shouldn't forget about the Apoc. Maybe there is another Apoc. We haven't seen any influence beside the Deuces, Wilds and the single Apoc yet. And the Eater, yeah, the Eater of course. Eater might be a one-off, so the 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. But I don't think you run Eater if you run only a single Apocalypse. That doesn't sound doesn't sound too good. Both players thinking a lot about their outs. So the game will be over very soon because there's only 9 cards in R&D left. Maybe the preemptive action was a one-off and Osglade don't have a way to bring it back again. At least having some money here with the hedge fund now. She really needs the monies. Installing an ice on HQ, that might be the IP block. Paying 1 to prevent the expose and drawing a single card, okay. Every draw here makes the game one turn faster, or it's over one turn faster for each draw. But I think she's looking for the winning breaking news here, which sounds okay. Maybe she gave up on the boom idea. Still 4 agendas in the game. That's the Mausolus. Just running through the Mausolus. So she was discarding, yeah, the Data Raven. We knew the Data Raven was. The hard-hitting news was discarded. And the boom is still sitting in there. I'm thinking a little bit about the general plan from Sync. I think the deck is very ice light, and even the ice isn't, yeah, okay, Mausolos, IP block, slot machine, that's cool and okay, but that is no ice where you can build a remote off, I think. At least not a good remote. And if you want to go for the breaking news into exchange or breaking news into kill, you somehow need to be able to defend the breaking news installed on the table for at least one turn. And that can be very difficult, I think. So there is another Dean Lister, there is the first inside job, inside jobbing the slot machine, bypassing it and just encountering the IP block, and now he needs to use the Dean Lister, pump up the strength of Omakua by 2, because he has 2 cards in his grip, paying 1, 2 breaking the enter run subroutine and seeing a single card from R&D. Has exactly the Bellona credits. Nothing. Seems like nothing. Maybe it was an ice or another operation. Another exchange of information would also be game here. Maybe it's also a one-off, and the one-off is also in archives and there is no way to bring them back. Seven cards left in R&D. I think if Osglade had the winning breaking news. No, she doesn't. She's playing consulting visit into closed account. Okay. A lot of tech punishment. A lot of tech punishment. Like the old school tech punishment with closed accounts is still good. Still good. Exchange is also good. But I don't know how many outs Osglade has here. Except the one of breaking news. So Losky needs to find the one of breaking news. And now getting into a server might be complicated. You can always face tank through the Mausolos, I think, to get up to 4. 4 Amakua counters, then click for credits and run R&D. There's another Apoc, another Bankroll, another Falsified, also very good cards. Falsified might be dead. NGO front, no trash because no credits. That might be viable next turn for Osglade if she don't top deck the winning agenda and going for the NGO. Just clicking for credits here to be able to next turn run R&D. So agendas must be clumped somewhere. They must be somewhere. Seems like still not the winning agenda. I don't think Osglade needs to think about that hard if she just top deck the breaking news. Where are my outs? If it's really the case that there is no more recursion and there is no more kill threat or no more exchange, yeah, I think that's the case. That's why she is dropping another ice on R&D, and she's just waiting it out for the breaking news. She's just waiting. And Lost Geek is pressured to find this breaking news or game's over. If he can find this breaking news, he doesn't win the game because he will be just on 4 agenda points. But I think Osglade will just be decked. Because she can't open up any remote, and yeah, even if she's open up a remote, I think Lost Geek can just tank through any ice here with the Amakua. And time is running up very, very soon for Osglade with 5 cards left in R&D. very long game here. Turn 22, Lost Geek, clicking for credits, running last click, R&D. Ice can't be that bad, you can just face tank through the slot machine and just let it fire. You break the last sub from the IP block, and if this is another Mausolus IP block, I don't know what else is left here. Maybe ice wall, you can just run through everything. You don't care about the ice, I don't know what kind of ice you want to install in res here. So there are two more Apocs, ooh, okay. Yeah, but he will never be able to Apoc anything here. Okay. And breaking this up and gaining another tag. Seeing unseen card. Nothing again. Nothing again. Oh no. Oh man. Where are the agendas? Where are the agendas? Maybe they are in HQ. Okay, Oscillate decided to purge. Yeah, now it's getting complicated. Now it's really getting complicated to get Aumakua tokens here. So the Mausolus has free advancement. So it's becoming the Super Mausolus. You can't face tank it anymore. R&D is R&D for the moment is protected by the IP block, by the end to run, and I don't know what the HQ ice is, but I'm also quite sure it's either the IP block we saw in HQ before or any other end to run ice. This geek is drawing up, maybe he has another Dean Lister in hand. Okay, two cards left. Does Osglade have the game right now? No. No, no, but she's looking for it. She is looking for it. And she's thinking about, okay. Yeah, maybe she should keep it cool now. I think R&D is safe for at least one turn. Just make sure you don't lose the breaking news from your hand. But she's on 7 credits, IP block is only 2 credits, so she can rest the IQ, HQ ice. And I think she have it. I think right now she have it in hand, and yeah, maybe in archives. Maybe there are 2 Bellonas in archives, who knows. There are still spear phishings and inside jobs. I think he has 2 Apocs in hand, but he can't play the Apocs. Okay, discarding the falsified, which is fine, discarding the diversion, which is fine. Okay, and I think here it is. There is the breaking news. Okay, ooh, wow, down to the last card. Whew, that, ooh, that was a close game. Well played, both. That was fun. And let's check the next round. Now, well, not the next round. How do you pronounce it? What is it called? The rematch. Oh, we will see Hoshikoshiro versus Sports Metal. Cool. Really looking forward to the Sports Metal deck. We have a keep on both sides and we have a violet level clearance into 2 ice. And discarding 2 cards already, that was a furious start, but already has the monies. Going for the 0 Paladin Poemo. Okay, now they really changed all the artworks from the alt arts that you could win on Worlds. That 0 is also cool. Is this Nat sitting there? He has kinda strange arms and strange legs. He looks a little bit, I don't know, like a monkey from the proportions. But that's still fine. Artwork is cool. Okay. And oh, this is a CVS. Purging virus counters. installing Ariseki, Paladin Poemo, Delicast, there's a lot of money coming up for Hoshikoshiro. Very fast, the labor rights are also labor rights. The labor rights kinda become mandatory in so many Anak decks. If you think about when they were released back in the days of I think it was the Magnum Opus? Yeah, the Magnum Opus. It was one of the Magnum Opus cards. Nobody played it. Nobody played labor rights. But right now, Recursion is back again. Labor rights is kinda the new. Oh man, I forgot the name of the old card when you can put back one card or Déjà Vu. Genau, Vujade. Labor rights is the new Déjà Vu. Okay, let's concentrate on the game. Liberate accounts, moneying up. Lost Geek is Biotic out here, going for the fast advance. An ABT, accelerated beta test. Haven't seen those one in ages. So this is his throwback card. Very, very cool. Very cool. He's looking at the top three cards of R&D. If he can install anything, he can install and res it. And the rest gets trashed. I like this card. It was a little bit broken back in the days because you could play around the knowing how many ice you still have left in your deck, but I always loved ABT. Cool to see it back in action, and cool to see it in the hands of Lost Geek. I think he knows what to do here, and of course I love Sports Metal. Sports Metal is the best. Okay, installing a Hippo here. Playing very fast. She has the MK Ultra for the drafter. If she wants to, all servers are blocked here. Don't let Hoshikoshiro switch. Switch to the other side. Going for the zero. If it was, a lot of card draws coming in. She might be looking for breakers, for the heap breakers, another draw into a sure gamble, and discarding three heap breakers. Discarding Dirty Laundry, sure gamble zero. So no, where are the breakers? Where are her breakers? I think she was thinking about if you draw like four or five cards a turn, you find at least one of them. 24 credits, but no way into any server. Maybe Lost Geek is seeing his chance of slamming something into the remote. Install advance. The CVS maybe tells us that there are Cyberdeck sandboxes in the decks, in the Sports Metal deck. Another zero draw, another IFAD worse draw. Okay, installing hard install the Black Orchestra. For the gatekeepers, maybe playing a stim hack. Okay, if there is a barrier, that is an end run here. If there is an Hagen would be terrible. There is no paperclip. No, there is no paperclip. Hagen would be worst case. Okay, Plus Geek decided to not res anything. Okay, this was a Vitruvius with a counter on top, using Sports Metal to draw up. Okay, Rebirth was trashed by the brain damage, and there's a paperclip now. Okay, now we have all the breakers. And install, advance, and playing Violet level clearance. Okay, Lost Geek is drawing and burning through his deck like a madman. I don't know. So, it's Hoshikoshiro, she has 26 credits, you have the Riseki, you have the Paladin Poemo, you have all the breakers ready, and I don't know. Can you text this out, or do you just go for the Biotic? So 3 Vitruvius, 3 ABT. That is already enough to win the game, just with the Biotics. If you can recur the Biotics, of course, or at least one Biotic. Maybe there's a either Hyperloop extension or the Megaprix. Oh, it's a tier. Ooh. That nasty Nordic god. What do you do here? How many credits is it if you want to break? Yeah, we see 2. That was paid by Paladin Poemo. And you need it 4 times. Is it 12 credits? 12 credits to break the tier. Okay. There's a GFI. Okay, so no one pointers. This might be 3 ABT is 6. 3 Vitruvius is 12. And 3 GFI is enough. Yeah, it's 21. And the GFI is a very good idea because the runner will always need at least 1, 2, 3, 4 agendas to win the game, and you might be only need 3 agendas to win the game. So the strength of global food here. And the rest here, there is the possibility to take out the runner. I wouldn't expect such a big ice in a sports metal deck. Yeah, okay, well, with ABT, if you can fire the accelerated beta test and you find a tier and you can res it for no cost, wow, beautiful. There's another GFI that was discarded. And there are 2 Hagens, both Hagens. That Hagen would have really been helped with the Vitruvius here, but you never know. You never know. Ooh. There's a spicy legwork coming in. This might be game. This might be game. Okay, removing it. Removing the drafter with the hippo. Passing HQ eyes. Seeing a gatekeeper. Surveyor. And a biotic. Something to server 1. Playing a preemptive. That is good. There is the recursion for the biotics. Okay, he decided bringing back 1 biotic. Maybe you want to bring back Hedge Force? I don't know. Or maybe the. Okay, biotic, biotic, Hedge Force. A lot of big eyes in his deck with the Surveyor. He might be gambling for firing another ABT. Oh, there is a Maw. Okay, there is a Maw. Maw is good. Maw is very good. Very expensive, but 3 credits from Paladin Poemo, that's fine. And with Hoshikoshiro, you have at least a lot of pressure or pressuring the corp from resing the eyes. Because every access. Oh no, that's the winning agenda. There was the winning Vitruvius. I think the legwork before really hit 3 cards. I think there were at least the Vitruvius were in the deck. Okay, this was a very long game and a very short game. I'm hoping you had fun, and we see you in round 3 if you want to. Bye bye.